Raven to Nest! I've got two Republic fighters on my tail. I can't shake them. Requesting backup!
This is Major Anri of Raven Squad, still under fire! Come on, I need help down here! Read me!
I read you, Major. Loud and clear.
Really appreciate that whole sensing danger through the Force business, my lord. It saved my neck more than once.
What's going on? Where did those Republic fighters come from?
See that dreadnought? Meet me there. We'll get you all caught up.
I need the rest of them ready to go in 10, Captain. Understood?
Right away, Major.
Welcome aboard the Executioner, my lord. Wish I could have organized a welcome party, but we need your help straight away.
I thought I was here to support the Empire's Colto operation. What are the Republic forces doing on Manan?
Being a pain in all our backsides? Colonel Cord was running a pretty tight ship with this Colto operation. We dropped mining platforms right on the water. Real state-of-the-art stuff. Got everything up and running quick. Harvesting, refining, shipping. We were up to our necks in Colto. The Sailcath didn't even know what hit him. Until the Republic got a whiff of what was going on.
Who is this Colonel Cord you spoke of?
My new commanding officer. Raven Squad was transferred to Cord's regiment not long before he kicked things off on Manan. Once the Republic brought the big guns, the locals started to put up a fight. Some of the Sailcath even got organized enough to take over our Colto refining station. That station was our base of operations, and now our people are stuck inside, including Colonel Cord. All our platforms are cut off from each other. Whole thing's a mess. If we want this operation back on track, first thing to do is kick the Sailcath off our base, which I can't do alone. Could really use your help down there.
Whatever you desire, I am at your service.
You really are too good to be true, aren't you? I've already given the order to ready as many troops on board as we can. Just need to get them down to the surface and...
Major Anri, the first dropship we sent down, it was completely destroyed as soon as it entered Manan's airspace. Our scanners show it was Republic anti-aircraft weapons.
Are the enormous guns mounted on this eyesore just for show? If you've got their weapons in your sights, take them out.
We can't. Once we started the targeting sequence, their weapons disappeared from our instruments altogether.
How can that be?
Damn it! Don't know what the Republic's playing at, but I'm not sending any more soldiers down until we find out. As long as those Republic dogs are helping the Sailcath, our efforts on Manan are dead in the water, so to speak.
That's not an option, and there are other ways to solve this problem.
All right. What are you thinking?
You and I will retake your base. The Republic's weapons won't lock onto a small shuttle. You were able to escape Manan relatively unscathed.
Solid point. And once we take the Republic's fancy weapons out of the equation, we'll clear the way for reinforcements. You heard the plan, Vondrel? Hold down the fort up here. We'll signal when it's safe to deploy everyone else. It's great to have your help again. Now, let's show these kelp lovers what we're made of, yeah?
Mother Toon, open Lato Sag Le Vego, so that Volt Grav isn't filled.
I will never give up opposition on Manan, no matter how many chances you give us. The Empire needs more Koto than your tight-fisted government is willing to sell.
Was only lesson. Teto Zot, Apaza La Ko Zotrit, Oma Leos.
Hey, shark bait! Over here!
You must know that the Empire will be victorious. Here's your chance to join the winning side.
Tis tele tel, esiri tetel hoge.
On your feet! I want this place back in working order immediately! Taurus, get this display back online! Dar, re-establish long-range communications now! We've been cut off from the other platforms for too long!
Colonel Cord, sir. This is...
It is an honor to meet you, my lord. But as you can see, we are ill-equipped to properly receive someone of your stature. Where are my reinforcements, Major?
The Sith is speaking, Colonel. You will give your full attention when I am in your presence.
You are correct, my lord. Please forgive my negligence.
I know you're expecting a few more people, but that plan hit a bit of a snag.
A few more people? I asked you for an army, Major.
And if I bring you that army now, they're as good as dead. The Republic shot down our first transport. They've got some kind of stealth weapon system. It went dark on the executioner scanners almost as soon as it showed up.
Then we need to eliminate those guns. I want my soldiers down on the surface in one piece. The second our scanning instruments are functional again, we shall locate the Republic's weapons. Readings down here will be more accurate than on the executioner.
The Selkath did a real number on this place. With their home advantage and the Republic backing them up, they'll retake this position in no time.
What are you suggesting we do?
Colonel Cord finds the Republic's guns. We fix our defenses.
There are plenty around this platform, but they were destroyed or disabled by the ion blast the Selkath triggered. You'll have to repair all the defenses manually.
Sounds easy enough, especially for the two of us. I'm sure Darth Norok will be pleased at how well we're handling this, sir.
Who is Darth Norok?
New head of logistics on the Dark Council. Darth Shah's retired to some frilly palace on Dromon Kaas. Still wondering how she got Emperor Vauron to let her go. Colonel Cord manages the Koto operation, but this whole thing is under Darth Norok's jurisdiction. He gets final say on everything. Be nice if we could update him before we set off, sir.
I tried to contact him, but with everything that's happened, I'm sure he's on the move. Don't get your hopes up.
Good. Your endless missteps are becoming a considerable source of irritation.
I know things are grim, my lord. You have my apologies, but I and my associates are prepared to make things right.
See that you do.
Darth Norok has been briefed, and we all have our assignments. I want this entire operation back in working order. People will die without this Koto.
I understand the situation's urgency, but there was no reason I couldn't have spoken for myself.
Sir, the Selkath are launching another attack. They've breached the lower levels.
If those Selkath take this platform again, I'm afraid no one will be speaking to Darth Norok.
Leave the Selkath to us. We'll return once the defenses are repaired.
Very well. Good luck to you both. Hopefully you won't need it.
Good news, sir. We reactivated the defense systems. Making our way back to your position now.
Excellent work. But unfortunately, the job isn't over yet.
What are you talking about?
As Major Anri so eloquently reminded me, the Selkath have their home advantage of infiltrating underwater targets without impediment. As long as the Cellcath can so easily enter the platform's sublevels, our surface defenses won't be enough to repel them, as demonstrated by this second assault. The order just came down from Darth Norok. You're to deploy underwater defenses before you return. We have an assortment of mines that should do the trick.
This was Darth Norok's idea. Wasn't he the one who said the mines were a waste of time in the first place?
I sincerely hope that you're not questioning the word of a Sith, Major. I know you are smarter than that.
Well, if Darth Norok wants mines, then I guess we better get him some.
And where are we supposed to get these mines? Cord wasn't exactly clear about that.
Come on. There's a submersible droid in our mining facility that should make this easier for us. Just need to get to it.
This is a good start. Keep at it, Lieutenant. Lieutenant Dar has patched up our long-range communications. The holocalls aren't what I would call reliable yet, but we were able to briefly reach the Executioner. Unfortunately, we haven't made much headway in repairing our scanning equipment. We may have to rely on the Executioner if we're going to locate the Republic's weapons. How did things go on your end?
From the sound of it, Major Anri and I are the only ones who accomplished what we set out to do.
And the citizens of the Empire who benefit from this Colto will appreciate your efforts. Darth Norok made a brief appearance on the way to his next objective. I updated him on our progress and your success with the platform's defenses. He was quite pleased.
Can't you call him back? Sooner or later, we'll need to hammer out a plan with Darth Norok for after the Republic's gone.
Darth Norok's priority is getting the Colto mining operation in working order again. He won't be pleased if I interrupt his work.
After everything we've done, the least you could do is get Darth Norok on a holocall.
Fine. I can do that much.
It's the Executioner, sir. They managed to make contact again.
Put them through. They could have an update on the location of the Republic's guns.
Colonel, thank the stars we reached you. We just received a distress signal from our shipping docks on the surface. It's faint, but we heard enough. The Republic has overrun their position. The entire platform is in lockdown, and if we don't...
Blast! There's enough Colto sitting on those docks to secure many decisive victories for the Empire. We can't let the Republic get their hands on it. I need you both to stop them. Darth Norok?
It must be done. We must take control.
We will, my lord. We won't let any pubs off that platform with our Colto.
Should I try to get him back?
Don't think that's necessary, sir. Those Colto transports don't have pilots. Use this to send them somewhere. They'll get to the destination on their own.
We need to get this Colto straight to the heart of the Empire. I'm sending the transports to Droman Kaas.
Colonel Cord will love you for that. Seeing this.
Contact Cord. We need an extraction.
Way ahead of you. Here's hoping I can get through. Sir, I got a little surprise down here at the shipping docks. The Republic's guns showed up.
What about the Colto? Where is it?
Gone. Those guns destroyed some of the transports, but most are on their way off-world.
Which is great for you and all, sir. Unfortunately for us, the Republic's just dropped a lot of fresh troops on our doorstep. We're trapped in here.
I cannot send anyone to get you out, Major. Not while those guns are still active. Both Norak would not approve of me sending anyone else into this situation. You don't need me. I know that both of you will figure.
Think we can make it to that?
We'll handle it. And we'll bring down the Republic's guns on the way out. Darth Norok.
What in blazes are you doing here?
I'm helping Colonel Cord resume the Empire's culto operation here, like you ordered him to.
I gave no such order.
Is that? You've got to be kidding me.
Don't just stand there. Release me! At once!
I don't envy your position. It looks uncomfortable.
Take me to Cord. I will wring the air from that useless invertebrate's carcass for this.
What does he have to do with this?
If he had done what I asked in the first place, there would be no need for my presence.
What do you mean? Colonel Cord's done his best to keep this operation running for you.
I repeatedly told Cord his little Colto mining stations weren't good enough. The Empire does not toil and struggle for a mere trickling of resources. We take what we want. Cord had one objective. The complete subjugation of Banan. He refused to comply with my instructions. So I relieved him of his command. The Republic arrived at Banan as I began my descent to the surface. I had no time to act. In one swift moment, their forces destroyed our weapons, shot me down, and set upon me.
How can you call yourself Sith when you so easily allowed the enemy to capture you?
I have more than earned my position. A position that means I don't have to answer to your inane criticism.
Hate to break up this very productive discussion, but I can't land this thing without drawing attention. Too many pubs out there. But it's now or never. We won't get a better shot at taking out these guns.
If these animals are all that stand between me and an unyielding grip on Manan, I will eradicate every last one.
Here we go. Not a Selkath in sight. They must be putting a lot of trust in the Republic if they're letting this beast cruise around Manan without any local military on board.
Don't be absurd. There is no trust between Manan and the Republic. The Selkath want the Republic gone as much as we do. As much as they want the Empire gone.
I thought the Selkath helped the Republic destroy your ion cannon.
A brief association, in opposition of a common enemy.
How do you know that?
The so-called soldiers tasked with guarding me had many complaints about Manan's natives. The Selkath's displeasure at the Republic's presence was especially confusing for them. The Republic are aggressors here.
Self-righteous and unwanted invaders, though they pretend otherwise. And I will find a way to use their sanctimonious convictions against them.
All those power conduits we fried lead to manual controls on the bridge.
Can you use the controls to deal with the guns?
Does a hut have a tail?
Then we have our target. Let's go.
They must have known we'd make it up here. Our Republic friends locked this system down tighter than bantha hide.
Can you get in?
Oh yeah, no problem. And we destabilize enough of this thing's power conduits that I can rig the guns to explode from here. With plenty of time for us to escape, of course. Say goodbye to the Republic's shiny new toy.
Stop.
What's wrong?
Why destroy these weapons when we can take them for ourselves? Use them against the Republic, should they try to stop us again. Increase the output of these weapons as high as you can, Major. Make them so powerful that we regain our unquestionable dominance over this world.
Not an option, my lord. We shut down too many of the power sources. There won't be enough juice left to supercharge the guns and keep their targeting matrix online. I do what you're asking. These guns will fire on anything that moves. Cellcath, Republic, Imperials.
Good. That means no one else will be able to shut them down. When Cellcath's ships are obliterated by Republic weapons, their rift will deepen. The Cellcath can't fight on two fronts, and when the dust is cleared, Manan will belong to me.
You're there! Do you read? What's the status of those guns?
We're at the controls now, Colonel. But you...
Come in! Blast! I thought we'd worked out these comms issues.
Colonel...
Listen, if you can hear me at all, it is imperative that we destroy these guns once and for all. Our people need Colto, and what we're doing here is the best way to get it to them. But we can't continue if the Republic is breathing down our necks like this. Darth Nord's orders are clear. Destroy the guns.
Everything all right?
Focus, Major. Do as I command, and you shall be granted a reward befitting a conqueror of worlds.
I'm sorry, my lord, but this one gives the orders.
What do you think I should do, Henry?
Thanks for putting me on the spot, but since you're twisting my arm, I do what's best for my soldiers. And I don't think getting shot out of the sky by some overpowered light show is in their best interest.
I came here to help the people of the Empire, not expedite their destruction. Gut these weapons.
With pleasure. Countdown initiated. It gave us enough time to get back to the shuttle, but we still better move it before these things come apart on top of us.
You will not leave until you do as I say. Increase the damage of these weapons now, Major. Or you will both learn what happens when you defy a Sith.
Your impulsive decisions got you captured by the Republic, and now you expect me to aimlessly kill Imperials. You are a stain. An aberration, a degradation of the Sith. How dare you make demands of me?
That was the wrong answer. Slaughter. I am destruction. I am Sith.
Well, that's your cut into our escape time.
Then let's not waste any more time.
I've raised my brow at a lot of things you've done, but never in my wildest dreams did I think you were capable of something so blasted stupid.
Mind yourself, Major. I won't permit this insubordination while there's still so much work left to do.
Mind myself? Stars, you're brainless. We found Darth Norik, Colonel, and he wasn't too happy to hear about what you've been up to. You had the brass to speak for a member of the Dark Council without his permission, but that wasn't reckless enough for you. Not telling anyone that Norik was missing. Forging his orders. And the best part's gotta be how you dragged us into your stupidity. I know Norik was a pain, sir. And I know he was keeping you from supporting the Empire the way you thought was right. I might have understood if you had just told me about all of this from the start. But you lied to me. And that I don't understand.
Terrible things happen to those who try to deceive me. You're lucky I don't kill you where you stand.
Are you sure that impersonating a Sith is such a terrible thing? Because right now, you sound just like Norok. Where is Darth Norok?
He attacked us when we destroyed the Republic's guns. We had to kill him.
Then how can you blame me for what I've done? You saw for yourself what Norok does to anyone who opposes his greed. And you stuck by what you thought was right. Just as I did.
Other than making a complete fool of yourself, what exactly did you do?
Whatever mess you found Norok in was the result of his own arrogance. When I lost contact with him, I simply took advantage of his absence. My entire career, I've done nothing but prove my admiration for the Sith. I served without question, believed they had a right to rule the Empire. Until I had a chance to lead this operation, I cherished the idea that I was helping soldiers live to see another day. Norok, however, kept saying I needed to think bigger. He wanted all of Manan under his rule. But we didn't have the resources to sustain a prolonged occupation of the entire planet. It would have achieved nothing. Nothing more than a boost to Norok's ego. I refuse to sacrifice faithful citizens of the Empire for something so irresponsible. And I do not regret that decision. Or the decision to use Norok's name, if it means not one life will be wasted on a Sith ambition.
I see you finally solved your communications problem, Colonel. Now that the lines are open again, I need an update on your progress. Strictly going by who I see in the room, I'm assuming everything is going well.
That's correct. Colonel Cord, Major Anri, and I have worked tirelessly to bring the Culto Mining Network back to full efficiency. I think you'll be quite pleased with the results.
That's correct. And as a matter of fact, we just got a large Culto shipment off-world and dealt a crippling blow to the Republic's weapons.
Excellent. That is just what I was hoping to hear. I'll leave you to continue your work, Cord, but I expect another update soon. Krovos out.
I don't understand. I thought for certain my actions would have caused you offense. Why didn't you say something to Darth Krovos?
Norok told me himself that Imperial lives were expendable. He died trying to prove that point. I want those ideas to die along with him. If anyone asks, the Republic killed Darth Norok.
Don't think anyone here is going to say any different.
Well, then, thank you. Not for what you've done for me, but for what you've done for the Empire. Many will owe their lives to you. You've given us a secure foothold on Manon, which means a more certain path to victory. But there is still much to do. Speaking of which, we'd better get back to it. Unless you don't plan to stay, Major.
Of course I'm sticking around. At least until I find someone else to give you a kick in the pants when you get another one of these half-baked ideas. Colonel Cord's explained the situation to everyone who hadn't heard yet, even apologized. Didn't see one tear shed over losing Darth Norok. Thought that was interesting. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. Not too many of us were looking forward to taking over all of Manan. Now we can focus on what we came for.
I like it when you talk business. You sound so assertive.
Really? You ask anyone else, I say I run my mouth too much. Glad you don't mind. I've seen you in action so many times, and you still never cease to amaze. Not to mention all the times you've come through for me. You're probably tired of everyone constantly falling over themselves for you. I'm sure you don't need to hear me go on about how amazing I think you are. But I can count the number of people I trust on one hand. Every time we meet, you more than earn your place on that list. Hope you know how much I appreciate that.
If you want to show me how much you appreciate me, you can start by buying me a drink.
Not a bad idea, but I've got something better in mind.
You're right. That was much better.
Let's just hope we don't have to wait too long before we get to do that again. Anyway, I know you have a lot to get back to, and I don't want to keep you from it. Thanks for sticking around and seeing this through.